Yeah.
Okay, cool. I was watching a program the other week, and the main character was kind of insecure about his manhood, and he convinced his friend to, you know, take a look just to make sure he looked too small. And his friend, to make him feel better, he, you know, he presented himself, and the main character was like, "Oh my God, what's wrong with your penis?" And his friend was like, "It's my foreskin. Not everybody in Manhattan is Jewish." And it reminded me of a question that I once had, that I was raised Roman Catholic, why was I circumcised? At the time, I didn't feel like asking my mother about my genitals, so I decided to go on the internet to kind of figure out what was the answer. The first thing I wanted to know was, what exactly was I missing? What I found were a few diagrams. This diagram shows what the normal penis looks like with the foreskin and what it looks like without it. The next thing I encountered was how the procedure was performed. This would be a normal procedure to remove a male foreskin. Doesn't look too pleasant. And of course, like any good medical procedure, there is always tools designed to assist. These are some diagrams of those devices. I looked at these, I winced quite a bit, and then I decided to continue on and try and figure out why this was done. What I came across was doctors opposing circumcision. You have in front of you the homepage of that website. What Doctors Opposing Circumcision did was create a 64-page genital integrity policy statement. Within that policy statement, which I actually went through and bothered to read, they give a name to circumcision. They call it male genital mutilation. I recognize this because I had heard of female genital mutilation. Does anybody happen to know what exactly that is? The purpose of this is to create sex as only a reproductive act, and also to decrease the chances of infidelity in the female. Now, oddly enough, what people, most people don't understand is that this has the same effect on a circumcised penis. Now, what I thought was, female genital mutilation is obviously not accepted in civilized society. Why is circumcision? What I did was I looked through respectable periodicals, such as the American Journal for Public Health, and I came out with two answers. That it was for a hygiene purpose and disease prevention. Now, in the matter of hygiene purpose, they basically just stressed that you don't have the additional care towards the penis to do. But in actuality, when you look at it, it's no more care than you would just to wash underneath your armpits. So how is that really a reasonable answer? I also found out that the foreskin actually acts as a natural protective agent, reducing the possibilities of urinary tract infections and actually improving overall penile health. Now, the second was, of course, about disease prevention. They spoke as it reduces the possibility of gaining HIV. But in actuality, we have these things for that. So what that thinking brought about to me was that basically, if you considered HIV like lung cancer, an uncircumcised penis is like smoking full-flavored cigarettes, while a circumcised penis is like smoking light cigarettes. Selling cigarettes on the basis that being light is healthier for you is obviously not done anymore. So how can they sell the same ideas to us with circumcised penises? To make matters worse, I found out about some mishaps. Through the DOC, the thing you have in front of you, I found out that the individual can lose proper usage of the penis, basically reducing the possibility of gaining an erection if the procedure is performed improperly. I also remember seeing an episode of Law and Order where an individual, when a circus act performed on him, was basically mutilated so badly that the parents chose to have the sex of the child changed. Now, you might say, well, that's a TV show. But in actuality, most things on Law and Order are based around real events. So at this point, I was shocked that such a decision would be made for me. So I decided to ask my mom, why did you do this? What was her answer? Because it was what people did. I was born in 1980. You know what else people did in 1980? They dressed like that. You know what else they did? They went with the mullet. You know what else they did? They walked around in their big, bushy, handsome mustache. We can look at these pictures and laugh, but these were the popular choices, just as circumcision is. The only problem is, I can't change the style of my penis. Circumcisions are so popular that resources like DOC have found that most parents choose to have their sons circumcised so they do not look different than other boys. Merriam-Webster has a definition I found. To make a difference in treatment or favor on a basis other than individual merit. What is it? To discriminate. Parents have chosen to have an operation performed on their child to prevent discrimination. We live in a country that has constantly worked to end discrimination. Parents do not choose to have African American children made to look more like Caucasians just to prevent discrimination. Parents do not have their baby girls changed into baby boys to prevent discrimination. So is a procedure with such negative effects really the proper choice for their son? I feel it is not. I feel that a fully healthy child should be left as he is. Males are born with foreskin and should retain that foreskin throughout their lives. What I ask of you today is not sign a petition. I don't want you to call your senator. What I want you to do is just consider what I present to you. Because sometime in the future, you will be soon bringing a baby boy into the world. And I want you to remember this crazy guy that stood up in front of you in your speech class and actually talked to you about circumcision. And I want you to remember it because maybe